Welcome back to your English class. Today we are going to read a new lesson. The name of the lesson is The Kindness of Lord Buddha. Here are a few words in the beginning of the lesson. I am reading and you follow. You must learn the spellings. Okay. Cousin. Swans, lesson, overhead, roadside, kingdom, blood, injured, evil, sorrows, relatives, wandered, properly, sickness. A beautiful story is told about the kindness of Lord Buddha. One day, his cousin Devdutt shot at some swans flying overhead. One of the swans was hurt in the wing. The bird fell to the earth. Buddha took the swan in his arms. He saw there was blood on the bird's wing. Buddha washed away the blood with water and tied up the injured wing with a piece of cloth. Soon the wing was better and the bird could fly again. Then his cousin Devdutt said to Buddha, "This bird is mine. I shot it." Lord Buddha said, "No, the bird is mine. I saved it. It cannot be his who wanted to kill it." There are many other such stories. They all show that Buddha had a kind heart. We see sorrow and suffering about us, around us. But we do not want to think about the sorrows and troubles of others. We want to think only how we ourselves can be happy. Buddha was not like that. One day, Buddha was riding along the road when he saw a man old and weak, unable to walk and hardly able to stand. "Who is he?" said Buddha to his servant. "Why has he grown so thin? Why can't he walk properly?" His servant answered, "He is an old man." "Then we all grow old and weak," thought the prince. Another day he saw a man lying ill by the roadside. He had never seen anyone ill before. "Health then flies from us in old age," thought the prince. Another day, he saw a dead body lying outside a house, ready to be carried away. A piece of white cloth covered the body from head to foot. The relatives of the dead were standing around the body, weeping and crying. The heart of Buddha was moved. He said to himself, "Thus death comes to us all. I wish that there were no old age, no sickness, and no death." After this, he gave his whole life to finding out some way to lessen the pain, the sin, and the sorrow in the world. He left his kingdom. He left his wife and child and went to live in the woods. For 7 years he lived there and thought about life and death, and at last he found the right path to happiness. He then came back from the woods into the world, and for 45 years he wandered about the country teaching the people how they could be happy. He taught them that it was their duty to be good and kind and to all animals, and that it was a sin to be cruel or to hurt anyone. He said, "All men are free and equal in the eyes of God." God loves the rich as well as the poor, the high as well as the low. One can please God if one lives a pure and holy life and speaks the truth and does no evil. So with this we come to the end of the story about Lord Buddha. He was a great person, noble man also, and you have read a lot of stories about Lord Buddha. You read this story again, once again. Read it with all your heart, learn the spellings and read it yourself so that you can yourself understand. Okay? So next time, next class, we will do the question answers. But remember your test dates and be prepared for the test. Okay? Till then, have a nice day. Goodbye. Stay home. Stay safe. Thank you.